See, last night, that was just a temporary aberration. And mark my words, from now on, no...
You were saying?
I must say, I'm impressed. I don't know, it's because Wade Barrett, he talks such a big game. I mean, he has to, he's the fearless leader of Nexus. He's got the resolve of Winston Churchill. And he's as tough as Snooki from the Jersey Shore. You see, Wade, I only say that because last night you tapped out. You tapped out. Apparently, all these people saw SummerSlam too. Well, what happened was, you tapped out, you caused Team Nexus to lose at SummerSlam, and now you're out here trying to talk about, oh, well, the loss will make us bigger. It will make us stronger. Wade, it's a lie. Right now, you're really thinking, to hell with Stallone, Willis, and Austin, the Nexus are the Expendables. And after that surprise last night, I bet you are kicking yourself directly in the fish and chips, thinking, why did I get rid of Daniel Bryan? You see, because when Daniel Bryan joined Team WWE last night at SummerSlam, he eliminated half of the Nexus by himself. For weeks now, the Nexus has been viewed as a group. An indestructible group, and after SummerSlam, one thing was made clear: you are human. You can be beat. So tonight we're gonna do something we've never done before. Instead of looking at you guys as a group, we're gonna look at you as individuals. And Wade, you may wanna pay close attention because you may find some flaws and decide where you went wrong. We'll take David Otunga. You see, David happens to be nothing more than a below-average male escort who clings to someone's arm on the red carpet. So proud of you, Dave. You've come so far. And Tarver! Well, to be quite honest, Tarver looks like some sort of MMA bank robber who works late nights as a male stripper. Those trunks get any smaller, we're gonna change the rating of the show. And is that Heath Slater? Or the chick from Wendy's? Oh! I'll let you be the judge on that one. This must be Monday Night Raw. We just got a Wendy's chant. That leads me to Darren Young. This one hits a little bit close to the chest. You see, because the very existence of Darren Young has proved my mother true of all these years. I thought she was lying, but she actually did have a lusty affair with Buckwheat. Then there's Justin Gabriel. I don't know much about Justin Gabriel, except he has an alternative way of thinking. For those of you who didn't get it, I will be at the late show to explain. Skip, you look like that was over your head. You didn't get it? Wait. Don't even say a word. You see, you're easy. I took a mind reading course in college. I can read your thoughts. Right now, you are thinking, meow, 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 heater, jumbo, tugboat. Like I said, Wade, the Nexus is nothing more than human. The fear you have instilled in the locker room is gone. Your psychological edge that you are some sort of indestructible force working for a higher power, see ya, bye. You lost last night, Wade, and Staples Center SummerSlam will forever be known as the place that Nexus was history!
Cena, you don't know what you're talking about.
No, 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 byproduct of a gallon of brandy in my mother's celebrity crush. You don't know what you're talking about. You see, you tapped out too. As a matter of fact, you gave up in under a minute. You want to cut to the chase? Your name shouldn't be Darren Young. Your name should be the Weakest Link. Ooh.